Raise your hand if you have a question.
Anytime you have a chance to win a game in this building is great. This is a tremendous building with a bunch of history. We talked about that this afternoon when we shot around. Mitch is doing a great job in a extremely difficult situation. To lose players to injury, to have a couple guys sitting on the bench that for some reason the NCAA says can't play, and I'm not going to say anything else about that, but he's got two guys that are that can't play, and he's got some injuries. Those young guards of him, 33, that kid number 5, Himes, they got my vote for all rookie first time around. So Mitch is doing a great job in a tough situation. I want to see at the end of the year who comes in here and wins, because this is a tough place to play. That being said, Dylon Cormier and I chatted this morning in the airport about how important this game was. He's a sophomore leader. Walker's my captain, but he's kind of quiet. And then Dylan's my other captain as a sophomore. The minute since he's got here, he just said, we're going to cut down the nets one day. And it's good to have a player tell you that, because sometimes I get down. You know, we didn't play well the first half against Marist. I'm really nervous. Siena's, since I've been in the league, that's the program to judge yourself by. So great win for us, and I was really happy. 4 guys in double figures, and we got a game Wednesday against George Washington on the road, and they're tough. I'll take any questions.
Mark?
Hi there. You forced 20 turnovers and 19 steals. You were credited for. Just talk about some of the pressure you're able to put on them. Particularly, you full-court pressed them a little bit, and it seemed effective.
Yeah, we've always been a pressing team, but you know, I can't lie. I saw the box score minutes and said maybe we should press more. Right, Dylan? So we three-quarter-quarter. I think you saw us run and jump, and we were trapping the ball screens. We don't do that as much as we did. We just said, we know how we play. We felt tired after winning Thursday. We knew they played Thursday. We saw the numbers and said we should press more. We made a decision this morning at shoot around. I'm actually dumb enough to listen to the players, but they were like, we should press them more, and I said, okay.
Jimmy, Siena's not really built to score in big chunks, so how big was the 13-2 lead right off the
bat? I think we won the game in the first. I mean, I didn't believe that, but Gary Williams was a big believer of that, of winning the game, like at the beginning of the game, the beginning of the half, you know, being prepared to win. I thought we won the game in the first 4 minutes, and that was on the kids, not on me. Dylan, you guys, we're ready to go, right?
All right.
You know, you can tell them what really happened in the locker room.
Well, we was amped for the game. This is a big test for us. You know, last year I came in here and I got hurt the first minute, so it was big for me personally. But as a team, we just want to win the next, so every game is important.
Raise your hand if you have a question.
Go ahead. Dylan, 4 for 4 from 3 in the first half. Can you just talk about how you were able to get open and how the shots were developing?
My shot was just falling this half, so I just stuck with it. As a team, if it's somebody hitting shots, we just keep feeding the ball. That's the type of team we are.